Hello everybody, welcome to Genus Healthcare Solution. Today we are going to discuss how to code knee arthroscopy surgery reports. To report knee arthroscopy, we should be aware of the anatomy of the knee. Unless we don't have complete information about knee anatomy, it's very difficult to code knee arthroscopy. Knee anatomy. There are three compartments in knee. Medial compartment, lateral compartment, patellofemoral compartment. The medial compartment includes medial femoral condyle, medial tibial plateau, medial meniscus. The lateral compartment includes lateral femoral condyle, lateral tibial plateau, lateral meniscus. The patellofemoral compartment includes patella, patellofemoral joint, intercondylar notch of the femur, suprapatellar pouch, trochlea. There are four ligaments in knee. Anterior cruciate ligament, ACL. Posterior cruciate ligament, PCL. Lateral collateral ligament, LCL. Medial collateral ligament, MCL. There are some specific rules which we need to follow during knee arthroscopy coding to get correct revenue for service providers. Here are some rules which we need to follow. Rule 1. If a physician performed both diagnostic arthroscopy and surgical arthroscopy, in that case we need to only code surgical arthroscopy, as surgical arthroscopy includes diagnostic arthroscopy which is not separately reportable. If a diagnostic arthroscopy leads to a surgical arthroscopy at the same patient encounter, only the surgical arthroscopy may be reported. Rule 2. If the findings of a diagnostic arthroscopy lead to the decision to perform an open procedure, the diagnostic arthroscopy may be separately reportable. Modifier 58 may be reported to indicate that the diagnostic arthroscopy and non-arthroscopic therapeutic procedures were staged or planned procedures. The medical record must indicate the medical necessity for the diagnostic arthroscopy. Rule 3. If an arthroscopic procedure is converted to an open procedure, only the open procedure may be reported. Neither a surgical arthroscopy nor a diagnostic arthroscopy code shall be reported with the open procedure code when a surgical arthroscopic procedure is converted to an open procedure. Rule 4. Arthroscopic synovectomy of the knee may be reported with CPT codes 29875, limited synovectomy, separate procedure, or 29876, major synovectomy of two or three compartments. CPT code 29875 shall not be reported with another arthroscopic knee procedure on the ipsilateral knee. CPT code 29876 may be reported for a medically reasonable and necessary synovectomy with another arthroscopic knee procedure on the ipsilateral knee if the synovectomy is performed in two compartments on which another arthroscopic procedure is not performed. For example, CPT code 29876 shall not be reported for a major synovectomy with CPT code 29880, knee arthroscopy, medial and lateral meniscectomy, on the ipsilateral knee, since knee arthroscopic procedures other than synovectomy are performed in two of the three knee compartments. Rule 5. CPT codes 29874 arthroscopy, knee, surgical, for removal of loose body or foreign body, and 29877 arthroscopy, knee, surgical, for debridement, shaving of articular cartilage, chondroplasty, shall not be reported with other knee arthroscopy codes 29866, 29889. With two exceptions, HCPCS code G0289, arthroscopy, knee, surgical, for removal of loose body, foreign body, debridement, shaving of articular cartilage, chondroplasty, at the time of other surgical knee arthroscopy in a different compartment of the same knee, may be reported with other knee arthroscopy codes. Since CPT codes 29880 and 29881, when performed, include debridement, shaving of articular cartilage of any compartment, HCPCS code G0289 may be reported with CPT codes 29880 or 29881 only if reported for removal of a loose body or foreign body from a different compartment of the same knee. HCPCS code G0289 shall not be reported for removal of a loose body or foreign body or debridement, shaving of articular cartilage from the same compartment as another knee arthroscopic procedure. Coding tip. HCPCS code G0289 is used for Medicare to report the procedure in that description when performed in a separate compartment of the knee during the same operative session. It is not appropriate to use code 29877 even with a modifier. Example 1. A physician performed arthroscopic synovectomy in all three compartments of the left knee. Loose body removal in the medial compartment of the left knee. In this scenario, we will only code 29876. HCPCS code G0289 for removal of loose body will not be coded here. In this scenario, physician also performing synovectomy in medial compartment along with loose body removal, therefore it was not coded separately. Example 2. Physician performed arthroscopic medial and lateral meniscectomy right knee. Arthroscopic synovectomy in all three compartments of right knee. Chondroplasty in the medial compartment of right knee. In this scenario, we need to provide CPT code 29880, which states arthroscopic meniscectomy medial and lateral compartment. As per CPT code 29880 description, chondroplasty is always bundled with meniscectomy regardless of the compartment, so CPT code 29877 will not be coded in this scenario. Synovectomy can be coded along with meniscectomy if performed in two different compartments from the meniscectomy. In this scenario, even synovectomy performed in all three compartment but medial and lateral compartment synovectomy bundled with meniscectomy, and we need at least two compartment synovectomy to code along with meniscectomy, so CPT code 29876 is not coded. Example 3. Physician performed arthroscopic medial and lateral meniscectomy. Arthroscopic excision of loose body from the notch in the patellofemoral compartment. Arthroscopic chondroplasty medial compartment. In this scenario, we need to provide CPT code 29880 arthroscopy medial and lateral meniscectomy. As loose body removal done in separate compartment, patellofemoral, and no other procedure performed in that compartment, it will be coded with HCPCS code G0289. Chondroplasty done in medial compartment is bundled with meniscectomy, so CPT code 29877 will not be coded separately here. Example 4. Physician performed medial meniscectomy, right knee. Lateral meniscus repair, right knee. In this scenario, we need to code both the procedure meniscectomy as well as meniscus repair, as both procedures are performed in different compartments. 29882 arthroscopy, knee, surgical, with meniscus repair, medial or lateral. 29881 arthroscopy, knee, surgical, with meniscectomy, medial or lateral, including any meniscal shaving. As code description of both code states medial or lateral, we need to put modifier to distinguish both procedure, which will provide clarity that meniscectomy and meniscus repair are done in separate compartment. In this scenario, we need to provide 59 modifier with lesser RVU code procedure 29881. So final coding in this example will be 29882 RT modifier, 29881 modifier RT modifier. Example 5. Physician performed medial and lateral meniscectomy. Synovectomy in the patellofemoral compartment. Loose body removal in the lateral compartment. In the scenario, only CPT code 29880 needs to be coded. Synovectomy is performed in only one compartment, which is not reported separately with meniscectomy if only done in only one compartment. Loose body removal is performed in the lateral compartment where physician also perform meniscectomy, so loose body removal code G0289 will not be coded separately. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you would like to see more surgery videos,